Jacqueline Wilson is a fifth-generation cow-calf producer.
Traceability and data collection has always been really big in our operation. I remember going back into history, hearing about Grandpa writing cattle performance data on these like 8x11 note cards.
Fast forward a few decades to today's tech-savvy Wilson Flying Diamond Ranch.
A couple years ago, we were approached by a number of different companies to get involved in a blockchain project that we were actually able to tokenize a group of feedlot steers and market them as NFTs, which was something that had never been done before in the entire world.
An NFT is a non-fungible token or unique identifier. NFTs can digitally represent any asset. In this case, each head of cattle is represented by one NFT.
We were able to say to the consumer, okay, we raised this product. This is what we've done along the way. This is how we can verify it, and this is how we can get it to your plate. And as such, we could put a premium on that because of the fact that we were able to provide verification for that animal from the time it was, you know, raised to the time that it was marketed. It was an amazing project. A lot of great partners came together to see if there was a place for blockchain within the cattle industry, and I fully believe that there is.
Dana Schwenk of the Nebraska Brand Committee talks about one of those great partners, the bank.
We have bankers right now that just believe in the handshake principle. They say, fine, you've got 2,000 head of cattle, I'll give you 2,000 head apiece for those. Well, without having a true tokenized physical example, do they really have 2,000 head of cattle? Every bank should have a principle where their confidence level is not based on somebody's word anymore, but on the actual physical audit that we can provide that shows that these collateral pieces are real. We don't allow a car dealer to sell cars without having a VIN number, right? So for me, having an EID tag is the same as having a VIN number on an animal. It just happens to be that they move around where cars don't without a driver.
Bankers, lenders, insurers, auditors. If the data is on the blockchain, everyone saves money and time on a reliable, secure platform.
We're taking that same concept behind that NFT project, and we're now incorporating into our direct-to-consumer business, Flying Diamond Beef. We rolled out a new product line, and the whole purpose behind that was to not only to go back and have complete traceability of that animal back to birth, but also be able to provide additional data to the consumer and talking about what we're trying to do to make it a more sustainable, carbon-friendly, climate-friendly, earth-friendly product line. And so we're trying to verify a lot of that stuff too currently. And in turn, we're able to add our own premium onto it at our store checkout.
So what's next for blockchain in the beef business?
We need to have some cohesiveness, and we need to bring everybody together and have those common goals and principles and saying, okay, you know, we understand that there's a place for blockchain, we understand there's some excellent benefits from blockchain, but let's now all get on the same page and be sure we incorporate it in a manner that's very beneficial to the industry as a whole.
Nate Weathers of Weathers Farms has concerns about traceability in the supply chain once the cattle go to the processor. But he also sees the potential of the right technology earning him a premium.
I think the technology is there because where our cattle go to the processing facility with an EID tag, that EID tag can get scanned. It's gonna take a little bit more work on the processing side because they have to make sure that that animal does not get commingled with any other animals. I'm actually kind of excited because I think we're actually pretty close to that. Right now, the hiccup is trying to figure out exactly how to keep that so that when you go to King Soopers, it's got a QR code. It brings up Weathers Farms. Here's everything that we've done. You know, we try to raise everything in a sustainable manner.
It's definitely not something that I want to see mandated because it can provide a premium for producer. And at the end of the day, you know, it's nice to be able to do the work and at the same time be rewarded for the extra work.
What Jacqueline sees for the future of beef and blockchain technology is already happening with grain.
GrainChain really uses blockchain technology because we found a need.
In our next video, we'll see how users in the grain supply chain are making money and getting paid immediately through smart contracts.